Larry from Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Persistent.
What does the word persistent mean?
Persistent is when you keep trying at something.
You try really hard and you don't give up.
You keep trying until you get it right.
Keep listening for the word persistent today on Sesame Street.
Persistent.
That's the word on the street.
Sesame Street. You know, it's gonna be such a gorgeous day today.
Gordy, come on, you're gonna miss it.
Miss what?
Well, today is a special day on Sesame Street, Gordon.
Oh, really?
Today is who can wear the most hats on their head day.
Who can wear the most hats on their head day?
Yep. Oh, it's starting, Gordy, it's starting.
Who can wear the most
hats?
So you know what? We just have to wait for Elmo,
Elmo for Gordon.
Yeah! Wow! Look at all these hats!
Yeah!
I guess Elmo wasn't kidding, huh?
Hey, Uncle Gordon, you think you might want to play the winner?
I think I'll just watch.
All right.
Yeah, let's
here
go.
We go.
Yay!
And welcome to Who Can Wear the Most Hats on Their Head Day. Find out who can wear the most hats on their head.
Yeah. Wow! I never knew that wearing hats could be so exciting.
Okay, that's one hat. One hat. Two hats. Two hats. Three hats. Three hats.
Okay.
Four hats.
Whoa.
Four hats. That's one, two, three, four hats for Elmo.
Yay!
One, two, three, four hats for Zoe.
Wow, looks like Elmo and Zoe are tied. Whoa, hey, what's that mean?
That bell means it's time for our first Who Can Wear the Most Hats on Their Head Day Challenge. Chris, what is it?
Elmo, Zoe,
yeah.
Without having the hats fall off your head,
yeah.
You must each say the alphabet, while standing on one leg.
Wow.
Drums, please.
Whoa. I wonder if he's gonna do that all day.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
And go.
Yeah. You see that? You see that? They did it. Where'd the drummer go?
More hats!
Let's add more
Can they balance more hats? Whoa! I should have known that was coming.
And that's one more hat for Elmo.
And one more hat on Zoe's head.
Yeah. And that's two more hats on Elmo's head.
And two more hats on Zoe's head.
Wow. And that's three more hats on Elmo's head.
And three more hats on Zoe's head.
How many hats are they each wearing now?
I can answer that.
Who are you?
I'm the hat check girl. It's my job to check the hats. Sorry, I'm late. There was a lane blocked on the BQE. Uh-huh. So, what's your name?
Zoe.
Zoe. How about you?
Elmo.
Elmo. So, Elmo, Zoe.
Yeah?
How many hats did you have on your head to begin with?
Four.
Four?
Yeah.
And how many hats did these guys just add?
Three.
So it's four hats plus three hats. Easy. Let's just count and see how many you got.
Okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Four hats plus three hats makes seven hats. Seven hats all together. Let's see you, Zoe.
Okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Four hats plus three hats makes seven hats altogether for you, too.
More hats! This time I'm ready for that little drummer boy to pop up right here.
That's one more hat for Elmo.
And one more hat for Zoe. Yow.
And two more hats for Elmo.
And two more hats for Zoe.
What's wrong?
I'm out of hats.
Oh, you know what? I am too.
Well, we're out of hats!
But you can't be out of hats!
It looks like we have a persistent hat-wearing bunch here today, Chris.
We sure do, Alan.
Hey, wait! I have an idea. That's three more hats on Zoe's head.
And that's three more hats on Elmo's head.
What's that mean now?
That bell means it's time for our next Who Can Wear the Most Hats on Their Head Day Challenge! Chris!
Hey! What is it this time?
Elmo!
Zoe!
Yeah?
You each had seven hats on your head.
We know that.
Then we added three more hats.
Uh-huh.
Without counting, estimate how many hats you have on your head now.
Huh? Estimate? What does that mean, Chris?
Estimate means make the best guess you can.
Okay, let's see. Elmo had seven hats on his head. Then Alan added three more. Elmo guesses he has nine hats on his head.
Oh. Zoe?
Right. Yeah. Let's see. Seven hats then. Three more hats. I'm gonna estimate 11 hats. Whoa.
Okay. Well, judges.
Stand back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven plus three more makes eight, nine, ten. 10 hats altogether. 10 hats? You estimated nine.
Yeah.
Nine is less than 10. You were off by just one.
Is that good?
That's good.
That's good estimating.
Me, do me now.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven plus three more makes eight, nine, 10. 10 hats altogether.
Yeah.
10? And you estimated 11.
Yeah?
11 is more than 10. You were off by just one as well.
Hey, good job, Zoe.
Yeah.
That was some good estimating.
Okay, then, that's 10 hats on Elmo's head and 10 hats on Zoe's head, and we're out of hats.
There you are, Alan. That makes it a tie. Yeah.
I'm sorry, you guys, but we're out of hats.
What? Where am I? Oh, hi, Reuploaded for that.
Yay!
Abby!
All right.
Yay!
Wow.
Okay. Well, I don't quite remember how it goes.
Listen, if you don't quite remember how
it
goes.
No, it's okay. I just know that it needs a rhyme. Something that rhymes with hats. Like bats! Yeah! Bats rhymes with hats. Hats, bats, bats, hats. Okay, here goes. Whittle, biddle, diddle, hats. Whittle, biddle, diddle, bats.
Abby, there are bats on their heads.
Whoa. Yeah, but Alan, look, the bats are wearing hats.
Ah, there you are, my pretties. One moment you are there, the next moment you are gone.
Hi, Cat.
Ah, greetings. An interesting gathering. May I ask what the occasion is?
Well, actually, we're having sort of a counting contest.
Yes, I can see that now. It must be who can wear the most bats on their head day.
Actually...
I shall count and find out.
Yes. Hmm.
That is one, two bats on Elmo's head.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. And one, two bats on Zoe's head.
Yeah, whoa.
Congratulations, Elmo and Zoe. It is a tie, which means we have two winners. One, two. Yes, I love this game. Come, my pets. Come. Yes, I know it was exciting.
You know what, guys? I think you're just going to have to settle for the hat you have on.
Wait. Elmo can wear more hats.
Me too.
Well, wait.
I remember. It's not a rhyming word, it's...
Oh, Abby!
I got it. Whittle, biddle, diddle, hats, 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 hats!
Whoa.
Maybe too well.
Whoa. I'm good.
Don't you just love the smell of clean, freshly laundered clothes?
Just one more block, and I will have finished my perfect replica of the Great Pyramid of Khufu.
About. Who won?
Yeah, who wore the most hats on their head?
Yeah.
Zoe, I'm not sure.
Oh.
No, but I am. Come on, everybody, let's count.
Oh, okay.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. There were 30 hats on Zoe's head and 30 hats on Elmo's head. Mm-hmm. It is officially a tie.
Good.
So did you, Zoe.
Oh, thanks. Come on. Let's go play something else like, dress up.
Okay, but no hats.
No.
No
hats.
For sure.
No hats.
Yeah. Oh, brother, what an adventure that was, huh, Abby?
You're telling me, Gordon. I'll never say whittle, biddle, diddle, hats, hats, hats again.
Hey, Abby!
Hi, I'm David, and today I'm here to tell you about the word persistent. Persistent means not to give up, even when things don't go the way you want them to.
Mr. David, please play soccer with Elmo?
Not right now, Elmo. I'm in the middle of something.
Oh, okay.
Okay, back to persistent. Here's an example. If you want to learn how to dribble a ball like this, you have to keep trying and trying. You have to be persistent.
Mr. David, are you ready for Elmo?
Not yet, Elmo.
Oh, okay.
And if you want to be able to bounce a ball on your head like this, you can't give up. You have to be persistent. So if you really, really want to do something...
Mr. David, please. Can Elmo and Mr. David play right now? Please.
It pays to be persistent, like my red furry friend here. Come on, Elmo, let's play.
Persistent! Don't worry, Mr. Beckham. Elmo will take it easy on you.
It's almost time for Abby's Flying Fairy School. But first, we're gonna drop it like it's hot, because it's time to freestyle with the letter U! Let's all shimmy, let's all shake, let's make the sound that the letter U makes.
U!
Now I got something for you and me to do. Let's come up with words that start with U.
Unicorn.
Under.
Uniform.
Up.
Unicorn.
U!
We're not done, we're not through. Let's hear more words that start with U. What?
Underpants.
Say what?
Underpants.
Come on, everyone. Let's groove. Let's dance. Let's shake a U or shake your underpants. Great U song. Yes, it's true. Let's see more on the letter U.
Letter U. Think there's no word. Let's start with the song. Umbrella. Oh, boy, oh, boy. Oh, letter U. Come back! Umbrella is a word that starts with U. Umbrella! Can you say umbrella? Umbrella! Now sing with Cookie Monster! Ha ha!
It's time for
Abby's Flying Fairy School.
Yeah!
Look up high in the sky. It's a school, it can fly.
Let's all hurry to the Flying Fairy School. Grab your wand. Bring your wings. We will learn magic things. Let's all hurry to the Flying Fairy School. How to make us grow. To make us shrink.
Whoa!
How to solve a problem with a single twinkle thing. This school is really magic, and magic's really cool. Let's go in, let's begin at Flying Fairy School.
Attention, please. Attention, class. Attention, please.
Welcome to Flying Fairy School. Today's the day you earn your wings. Your fairy godmother wings, that is. Do you have your wands ready? If not, just use your finger, because it's time for the Cinderella Challenge!
Oh, boy!
Oh, no. I don't know anything about being a fairy godmother.
Oh, don't worry, Donegan. I'll help you. After all, my mommy is the fairy godmother.
All right, class. First, we have to pick someone to be our Cinderella.
Well, Cinderella is a girl, and Abby is a girl. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge.
Oh, come on. Cinderella doesn't get to do any magic.
Now, there's only one fair way to decide who our Cinderella will be.
Eeny, meeny, miny, ming, catch a fairy by the wing. If it hollers, say,
oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hurt you. I should have realized that fairy wings are very delicate. Then let go of the wing and sing, eeny, meeny, miny, ming. Blog!
Huh?
You will be pleased. playing Cinderella.
Me? Oh, but I want to do the magic.
I'm sorry, dear, but eeny, meeny is legally binding. You have to be our Cinderella for the day.
Aww.
Now, there are four magical parts to the Cinderella challenge. First, you must magically give Cinderella a beautiful gown. Second, you have to give Cinderella beautiful glass slippers. Third, you must change a pumpkin into something Cinderella can ride to the ball in. And last but not least, in order to earn your wings, you must get Cinderella to the ball by the time the fairy timer reaches 12. Now, let the Cinderella challenge begin!
Oh, the fairy timer's moving. What do we do?
First, we gotta get Blog a gown, remember?
Oh, can't I just wear a pantsuit?
Sorry, Blog, it must be a gown.
A gown, no problem. We just need a magic rhyme.
Oh, I'm not very good at rhyming.
Oh, don't worry, I am. Let's see, what rhymes with gown? Oh, I know. Gown, down.
Ah!
Oops, a little too dressed down. I'll try another rhyme. Gown clown.
I can't let the prince see me dressed like this.
Oh, dear. Gown jinx clown.
Ha! Help me! I'm gonna jump right back, gonna kiss myself. Gown!
Well, it's not working, and Cinderella can't go to the ball in town without a gown.
Hey, that's another rhyme. And maybe you can't go to town without a fancy gown. Oh, let's try it. Gown town. It worked! Blog's got a beautiful gown!
And it's surprisingly comfortable!
You've now completed the first part of the Cinderella Challenge!
Huzzah!
Oh, look at the fairy timer! It's already at 4!
Oh, then let's get to the second part of the challenge! We have to magically give Cinderella her glass slipper!
I can't work under this kind of pressure.
Don't worry, Gonagan. My mommy does this all the time. We just have to wave our wands and say, fragile footwear.
Fragile footwear. Here are your shoes, Blog. No, I think that these are too small.
Maybe I'm retaining water.
Clean up in aisle one. Oop, oop.
What are we gonna do? Blog's feet are so huge.
I prefer to think of them as big boned.
Maybe we just need to change the magic words to larger fragile footwear. Wave your wands.
Larger fragile footwear.
Oops. I think those are too large.
They're too heavy.
Clean up in aisle two.
Whoa, looks like we could use some help. Spot! Oh, Spot! How do we make slippers that fit Blog?
Fetch, Spot, fetch!
I made it! I'm gonna save this.
Let's twinkle think. Twinkle think. Oh, 12 might have something to do with the shoe. Oh, maybe 12 is the number of laces.
I'm not wearing lace-ups with a gown. That would be a fashion faux pas.
Oh, wait. Sizes. Shoe sizes are numbers.
Hey, yeah. Maybe he's size 12. Let's try size 12 fragile footwear. Wands ready?
Size 12 fragile footwear!
Ooh, I love the way these shoes make my calves look!
You did it! You completed the second part of the Cinderella Challenge!
Oh no! The fairy timer's already at 9!
Then let's hurry up and turn the pumpkin into a ride for Cinderella! Now where's that pumpkin?
Oh no! Niblet ate the pumpkin!
How are we gonna get Cinderella to the ball now?
Mrs. Sparklenose, does Cinderella's ride have to be made from a pumpkin?
Not at all! I love fairy improvisation! Go for
let's think. What else can we turn into a ride?
The least you can do for eating our pumpkin.
Beep, beep.
Oh, but I don't know how to turn a gerbil corn into a ride.
I'm not sure. I can try.
Well, hurry up! The timer's almost at 12.
Okay. Ride!
Oh, it's a boat!
But there's no water here! I need a royal hoopty with wheels.
Well, try again, Gonagan.
Okay. Wheels!
A tricycle?
Well, it does have wheels.
But I can't pedal in pumps. I'll go too slow.
Okay, got it. Fast.
A motorcycle.
Cool. And fast.
You completed the third part of the challenge.
Now we have to get Blob to the ball.
But the fairy timer's at 11.
Then let's ride.
Whoa.
I'm trying, but I don't even have a gerbil corn license. What? Now take us to the ball, please.
Well, I don't even know where the ball is or how to get there.
Well, I know how to get to a ball.
Well, not like the ball in the story, but that'll work.
You did it. You completed the Cinderella Challenge!
Yeah!
And it's all thanks to Gonagan.
Me?
Well, yeah. You're the one who figured out all the parts of the challenge.
I did, didn't I?
And that means fairy godmother wings for everyone!
To the fruit dance!
Yummy!
An adventure? Great! Because Bert and Ernie's great adventures are coming soon. But first, we're gonna check out
the number 14!
How many is 14?
I see pictures dancing in my head.
Get your sleep.
Buddy Bert.
What?
Buckle up and we'll fly away.
Whoa! Yeah!
We're adventuring every time the bed starts tapping. Something special's gonna happen.
This is kinda catchy.
My favorite kind of traveling.
Yeah!
We're adventuring. Come along with Bert and Ernie. We're gonna take a little journey. Bert and Ernie's great adventures!
Gee, Bert, isn't it fun being car mechanics?
Yep. Hand me that wrench, will you, Ernie?
And we're not just any old car mechanics. We're singing car mechanics. If your car is any trouble, we will fix it on the double. And when we're through, it will be good as new.
Ernie, stop singing and get to work.
Ah, hey, customers. What can we do for you, miss? And goat?
Something is wrong with our truck. Listen.
Worry not. If your car has any trouble, we will...
Ernie, enough already. I'll check the engine. You go check the air in the tires.
Okay, Bert.
Looks like someone's been tossing chewed up stuff in here.
Why, you naughty goat.
Ernie, that's way too much air.
There. All even.
Oh, thank you so much.
Come back again.
What can we do for you, ma'am?
I can't get my brand new car to move. Do you think you fellows can fix it?
Can we fix it? If your car...
Pull it, Ernie. Ooh. This may take a while, ma'am.
All right, then. I will go to my beauty parlor and return after I've been beautified. Ta-ta!
Tricky. I better get more tools.
Don't worry, little car. If your engine has some trouble, we will fix it on the double. And when we're through, you will be good as new. Bert!
What?
I sang to the ostrich lady's car and it danced.
Ernie, that's preposterous.
It did, Bert. Watch. If your engine has some trouble, we can fix it on the double. And when we're through, it will be good as new.
A dancing, bouncing car?
Told you, my singing fixed it, Bert. Come on, let's go for a test drive. Forget the key. This car runs on singing. La 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 la. Strap on your seatbelt, Bert. We're going into high gear. La 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 la. Sing with me, Bert.
Ernie, I think I just forgot every song I know.
Nonsense, Bert. You must know dozens of tunes. Guess I stopped singing. I can't do that in this car. Sing, Bert.
How do you control this crazy car?
Easy, Bert. You wanna go high, sing high like this. You wanna go fast, sing fast, sing fast, sing fast, sing
fast, sing fast. Ernie, watch out for those
cars! Relax, Bert. I'll put it into low gear.
Oh, no, not into a tunnel.
Don't worry, buddy. I can see the light at the end of the tunnel.
It's a train!
Quick, sing higher, Bert.
I've had it with this flying car, Ernie. I want to land right now.
Okay, Bert, then we have to la-la slower, la-la-la-la-la, and lower, la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
I'm glad that ride's over.
So, were you fellows able to fix my car?
Sort of.
You just have to sing to it.
Sing to a car?
Try it.
I seem to be a little hoarse today.
I have a better idea. Just turn on the radio. Another satisfied customer.
You know what, Buddy Bert?
What, Ernie?
Being a singing car mechanic really makes time fly. Good night, Bert.
Good night, Ernie. Uh-oh.
Are you ready to take a trip to Elmo's world? Me, too. Cooperation.
La 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 la! It's time for
Elmo World.
La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's World. La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's World. Elmo's fist, no fish. His crayon too.
Sled in the rain.
Sleds are for the snow, not the rain.
Oh, Mr. Noodle, you forgot your sled.
Yay, you did it.
Good job, Mr. Noodle.
You wear a raincoat and boots.
Now open the umbrella.
You're still getting wet. Come on, Mr. Noodle.
You have to open it, Mr. Noodle.
Upside down.
Mr. Noodle.
Not like that. Hold the handle. Yeah, like that.
Yay, hey, Mr. Noodle.
What's he doing? Ah, Mr. Noodle's dancing.
That Mr. Noodle can dance.
Oh, very nice, Mr. Noodle. That Mr.
What do you wear when it rains?
Hi, Dorothy. This is what I wear in the rain, my rain poncho.
Hi, Dorothy. This is what I wear when it rains, my raincoat, my boots, and my umbrella keeps me dry.
This is what I wear when it rains, Dorothy, my raincoat, my rain hat, and my boots, so I can keep my feet dry. Then I can jump in puddles like this.
And thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Hello, baby. What do you wear when it rains? Oh, thank you, baby. Uh-oh. It's raining again. Elmo not to wear his umbrella hat when it rains. Oh, no. It stopped raining. Oh, well. So now...
You've got mail.
Hey, wait a minute. Elmo doesn't have to run.
You've got mail.
Stop, computer.
You've got mail. You've got mail.
Good. Oh, it's Elmo's friend Oscar who sent Elmo email.
Ah, you want to know what grouches like to wear in the rain? Nothing. I like to get wet and soggy. I like everything in my trash can to get wet and soggy. That's why I keep the lid up. Oh, and elephants like the rain, too. They like to splash in the puddles. Oh, this is a beautiful day. Now, scram. Wait a minute. I'm sending this email. I'll scram.
And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many leaves are blowing in the wind? Let's count them and see.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Leaves blowing in the wind. It was umbrella hat. Oh, boy. Boy, that really blew Elmo away. Great counting, everybody. Now, Elmo wants to learn more about other kinds of weather. Oh, boy. Like snow. Snow, but Elmo wants to know more about snow, don't you? Let's find out. Oh, it sounds like there's a snowstorm in Troy. How's the weather in there? Can you swim in the snow?
No.
But you can play in the snow. Can you make a birthday cake out of snow?
Yes, for a snowman.
Happy birthday, snowman! Can you count snow?
No!
Of course you can! You can count the falling snowflakes! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8! Oh, it's a winter wonderland of counting!
Thanks, Troy. Elmo's friend Alex knows a lot of different things you can do in the snow, and he told Elmo all about it.
I woke up in the morning, and it had snowed. It's great and winter when it snows. Everything was covered with snow. My mom helped me put on my snowsuit, because it was cold outside. I fastened up my snow boot, and we ran outside. There are so many things you can do in the snow. You made footprints. Animals make footprints too. I made a snow angel. The snow was cold. After
After that, my mom and I made a snowman. I put on his nose. We also had a snow fight. It was fun. Then we went sledding. I put on my helmet. I slid down the hill really fast. I didn't get too far. But I tried again. And again. And again. Sledding is great.
Yeah!
By the end of the afternoon, I got tired. Then we went home, and Mom made hot chocolate. I love hot chocolate, and I love the snow.
Elmo loves the snow, too. Oh, thanks, Alex. Oh, but Elmo still wants to learn more, don't you? How can we find out more? TV. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We can watch the Weather Channel. Oh, turn yourself on, TV.
The Weather Channel blowing into your home. And now, the Weather Lady and the Four Seasons.
Hello, I'm the Weather Lady, and this is my dog, Sunny Boy. We both love the weather. All kinds. Woof, woof, woof. He's not just a fair weather friend. Ah, woof. We love the seasons, too. All four of them. Woof, 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 woof. Take summer. The weather outside is hot and sunny. And sometimes it gets too hot in the summer to do anything except swim. Ooh, they don't call them dog days for nothing. After summer, autumn comes. It gets colder and windier. The leaves turn beautiful colors. And then they fall off the trees. Hey, that's what autumn is sometimes called, fall. Leaf it to Sunny Boy. Ah. Then it gets even colder and winter sets in. Sometimes it snows. Doesn't it, Sunny Boy? Then it starts to get warmer and the snow melts. And it's spring. Not too hot, not too cold. Just a little wet. Rain so flowers and plants can grow. Sometimes it rains so hard, even the weather lady has to go inside. Yes, you too, Sunny Boy. I love the weather. Whether it's summer or fall, winter or spring, and so does Sunny Boy. That's right, Dan.
Coming up on the Weather Channel, a snowman for all seasons.
Catch it before it melts.
Thanks, TV. But Elmo wants to learn even more about weather, don't you? How can we find out even more? Who could that be?
Whoa! Whoa! Wanna talk to a tornado?
Whoa! Any in!
I'm a storm with lots of strong wind.
A tornado's too windy, so a tornado has to go. Go, go, go! Whoa, whoa. Go, 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 tornado! Go!
You can't play outside when I'm around.
Boy, tornado's not kidding.
But most of the time, you can have a little fun in the weather.
Oh, really?
Sure. You can even play sports.
What sports?
Depends on the weather. If it's a nice windy day, it's great to go wind surfing.
Oh, no. Dorothy's imagining Elmo wind surfing.
Whoa! When there's snow, it's great to go skiing.
Thanks, Tornado.
You're welcome. Let's twist again sometime.
Okay, bye-bye.
Woo! Oh, Elmo loves weather. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the weather song. Here we go.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Weather.
Everybody!
Today by the letter, oh man, I can't remember today's letter. There it is. What letter is that?
U!
Right!
U.
It's the letter of the day. But what's today's number? There it is. What number is it?
14.
Right! 14 is the number of the day. So Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter U. By the number 14. This is Murray saying see you next time on the street. Peace.